team of the National Center of Afro-American Artists and the Boston Merengue Committee are pleased to present Merengue, Visual Rhythms, Ritmo Visuales, a major traveling exhibition featuring more than 40 works by 28 historical and contemporary artists from the Dominican Republic for its only England stop. I'm here with Camilo Alvarez, co-curator of this event, Dominican descent as well. And Camilo, talk to me a little bit about these beautiful paintings and where the artist came from and sort of what is represented in some of these paintings here.
Okay. The exhibition is called Merengue, Visual Rhythms, Ritmos Visuales, and they're all Dominican artists. They're all, most of them are still, you know, if they're alive, they're still living on the island. And you know, they're painting, sculpture, and there's going to be a video in the back. There's some photos as well. They were all inspired by merengue. Merengue is the typical national dance of the Dominican Republic. Perico Ripiao as well, it's a different variation, which basically started in the countryside and then formally made it into the ballrooms of Europe and the United States. So they've always been working with this medium of the, you know, it's music is one of the most abstract of the arts, and in order to, you know, visualize merengue or the music is very hard. So that's why all these paintings, I mean, of course it is a dance, so it's very, very festive situation. The colors are strident, they're, you know, harsh colors sometimes, but that evokes the sounds that happen. But then it also, it's kind of a history lesson sometimes too, you know, it shows people in the countryside after a long, hard day, working in the fields or, you know, cooking for thousands, hundreds of people. Now they're, you know, at the end of the day, having a little drink, having a little food and dancing. A lot of the merengue also started as a political, you know, commentary on what was going on in the day. So, you know, if they were, you know, annoyed with their wages, if they were annoyed with the government, maybe the dictator, they would express it in the actual music. So besides it being a cathartic, you know, getting that aggression out in the music, but also in the dance. Everybody is, you know, very happy. You know, they're sometimes sweating as well. So that's part of it.
And I know we're sitting here in front of this gorgeous picture here, and you said this was one of your favorite pictures here. Talk to me a little bit about why it is one of your favorite pictures.
Well, it's one of my favorite because it's big. I mean, the figures are almost life size. And it gives a great introduction also to the typical instruments used in merengue, perico ripiao, which is the drum, the accordion, the guira, and
la guira, la tambora,
la guira, la tambora, el acordeón y la maraca. So, and now it's just shows the diversity. I mean, the accordion originated in Europe. You know, la tambora originated somewhere in Africa. The guira was like, you know, created by slaves to like, you know, just keep rhythm with what the working, the tilling in the fields. And so it's just, everybody's happy. You know, and the people that got to dance were the privileged few, you know, the ones that had the leisure, and they're all very well dressed. It's a very idealized situation. And then everybody back here is just checking out the musicians. They're like, oh, that sounds really good. Generations enjoying themselves.
It is a beautiful painting. Well, Camilo, thank you very much for the time. Before I let you go, you being Dominican and everything, we got an exhibit here in music. El Mayimbe, Fernandito or Anthony Santos?
Ooh, that's a hard one. How about Los Rosario? All of them, and 440, and all that.
He's throwing them all in that category. Back to you.
Que quema, hay cuantas mujeres buenas, la rumba está que arde, un palito.
fiesta, no me para nadie.